Hi dear students, welcome back to the class. The last video we had discussed about what food for energy and work. Yes, which kind of food helps for energy and work? Yes, that is carbohydrates and fats. Okay, so today we are going to discussing the topic food for growth. That is protein. So which food help us for growth? Yes, protein. Okay, so proteins are needed for the growth and development of our body. They also repair the damaged cells and help in the maintenance of body. These are called what? Bodybuilding food. Okay, so the protein is also called as what? Bodybuilding food. So the small children need more protein rich food because they are growing in all time. Okay, so the small children, they need what? Protein rich food because of their body it's growing. Okay, so what are the sources of protein? Yes, egg, fish, meat, pulses and milk are the sources of protein. Okay, so protein that need for our body for what? Growth and repair. Okay, and in some chemicals also in our body, that is enzymes and hormones etc. Okay, so these needs for carrying out various body processes. So the protein is most important component of these various processes. Okay, so bones, muscles, skins, cartilages, blood, these also made with the help of protein. Okay, so what are the sources of protein? Milk, egg, seafood, beans, these are the sources of what? Protein. Okay, so next we are going to discussing the topic food for fighting diseases, which means vitamins and minerals. Okay, so first upon vitamins. Food rich in vitamins protect our body from diseases and keep us healthy and strong. They help us to have a good vision, healthy gums and a glowing skin. So what is vitamins? Vitamins need our body for protection from diseases. And vitamins perform different functions. For example, vitamin A that help for maintaining healthy eye and skin. And vitamin C that protect from diseases. And vitamin D that produces with the help of sunlight in our body. Okay, and these help to obtain calcium and similar minerals from the food. So these are essential for the growth and maintenance of teeth and bone. Okay, so what are the sources of vitamins? Milk, egg, fish, sunlight and green leafy vegetables, fruits. These are some sources of vitamins. And next is minerals. Minerals also help us to stay fit and healthy. They help in the formation of blood, bone and teeth. Main minerals needed by our body are calcium, iron, sodium and potassium. Calcium is needed for healthy teeth and strong bones. Iron help in the formation of blood. Once again, the minerals. Minerals that is required in small quantity but are very important for proper growth and maintenance of body. And these helps in digestion and nervous system. And some minerals that's required for making body structures, teeth, bone, blood, skin, hair and muscles. And iron, that is most important for the formation of blood, that's obtaining green leafy vegetables, lentils, beans, fruits like apple and watermelon etc. And calcium is most important for the formation of teeth and bones. These obtained from milk and egg. And iodine, and these need for making thyroid hormone. These need for carrying out chemical process. And iodine obtained from iodized salt, milk, ginger, leafy vegetables, fish and seafood. So The vitamins and minerals are needed in a very small quantity. Vitamins and minerals are known as what? Protective food. The rich source of vitamins and minerals are green leafy vegetables, fruits, milk and fishes, etc. Okay, so now we are going to discussing the topic roughage. What? Roughage. So roughage is the fibrous materials present in cereals, fruits and vegetables. It has no nutritive value and cannot be digested by our body, but it adds bulk to the food. Roughage helps in easy bowel movement and prevent constipation. Therefore, it is required for the proper functioning of the digestive system. So, what is roughage? So, roughage is also called as what? Dietary fibers. Okay. So, roughage, actually that is not a nutrient-giving food. Okay, this helps in removal of waste materials from the body. And these dietary fibers maintain digestive system healthy. And dietary fibers obtained in some food grains, pulses, fruits and vegetables. So now we are going to discussing the topic water. Water is also an important part of our food. It helps what? In the digestion of food, to excrete waste in the form of urine and sweat, okay, from the body, and to maintain our body temperature. We must drink at least 8 to 10 glasses of water every day. So what are the functions of water? Yes, water, that is essential for our body. And all the nutrients include water. And this water maintaining temperature of our body. And it helps what excess temperature is released through sweat. And this also helps to remove unwanted and harmful substances through sweat and urine. Okay. And this water also helps in the conversion of food into energy. And sources of water. What are the sources of water? Drinking water, tea, coffee, soft drinks, cooked food. I think all of you get the idea about nutrients. Yes. Okay, thank you.